Now see the first question of our exercise 7.4. Show that in a right angled triangle, the hypotenuse is the longest side. In this, we have to prove that the hypotenuse is the longest side of a right angled triangle. Now for this question, first we will draw a diagram of right angled triangle. Suppose this ABC is a right angled triangle which is right angled at B. Okay. Now the side opposite to the right angle is always hypotenuse. So AC is our hypotenuse. Now ABC is a right angled triangle, right angled at B. Now we all know that sum of all the angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equals to 180 degree. Why? Because angle sum property of a triangle. Now angle B is given as 90 degree. So angle A plus 90 degree plus angle C is equals to 180 degree. Now transpose this 90 degree to the right hand side. So it will become minus 90. So angle A plus angle C is equals to 180 minus 90 degree. Now angle A plus angle C is equals to 90 degree. That means the sum of this angle A and angle C will be equal to 90 degree. Now if their sum is equals to 90 degree, that means both the individual angles will be less than 90 degree. Okay. So in next line we will write angles A and C are each less than 90 degree. Okay. So we can see that angle B is equal to 90 degree and angle A is less than 90 degree. That means angle B is greater than angle A. Okay. Angle B is greater than angle A. Then the side opposite to angle B will be greater than the side opposite to angle A. So what is the side opposite to angle B? Side opposite to angle B is AC. So AC will be greater than side opposite to angle A. Which is the side opposite to angle A? BC. So AC will be greater than BC. The reason is side opposite to the greater angle is greater. Name this equation as equation number 1. Now angle C is also less than 90 degree and angle B is equal to 90 degree. So again we can write angle B is also greater than angle C. Now if angle B is greater than angle C, then the side opposite to angle B will be greater than the side opposite to angle C. So side opposite to angle B is AC. So AC will be greater than side opposite to angle C is AB. So greater than AB. That means AC will be greater than AB. The reason will be side opposite to greater angle is greater. And name this equation as equation number 2. Now see the first equation. AC is greater than BC. That means this side AC is greater than this side BC. Okay. Now see the second equation. AC is greater than AB. That means this side AC is greater than this side AB. So from both the equations we can see that AC is greater than both AB and BC. That means AC is the greatest side of this triangle and AC is hypotenuse of this triangle. So in our answer we will write, hence from equation 1 and equation 2 we can say that AC hypotenuse is the longest side of triangle ABC. Now see the second question. In figure, AB and AC of triangle ABC are extended to points P and Q respectively. Also, angle PBC is greater than angle QCB. Okay. Now, we have to show that AC is greater than AB. That means this side AC is greater than this side AB. So let's see the solution. First of all, this is a straight line. That means this angle plus this angle will be equal to 180 degree. So angle ABC plus angle PBC is equals to 180 degree. Now transpose this angle PBC on the right hand side. So angle ABC equals to 180 minus angle PBC. Name this equation as equation number 1. Now this is also a straight line. So this angle plus this angle will also be equal to 180 degree. So angle ACB plus angle QCB is also equal to 180 degree because of linear pair. Now transpose this QCB to the right hand side. So angle ACB equals to 180 degree minus angle QCB. Name this equation as equation number 2. Now it is given to us this one that angle PBC is less than angle QCB. In reason we will write given. Okay. Now what we will do, we will subtract both the sides from 180. So when we will subtract both the sides with 180, this less than sign will become greater than. 180 minus angle PBC will be greater than 180 minus this angle QCB. Why this sign will change? For this, I am giving you one example. Suppose these are two angles. 60 degree is less than 90 degree, okay? Now, if you will subtract both sides with 180, then 180 minus 60, and this will become 180 minus 90. Now subtract this. This will be 120 and this will be 90. So which sign will come between 120 and 90? This 120 will be greater. That means the sign is changed. So in the same way, this sign will also change. Okay. Now see equation number 1. 180 minus angle PBC is equals to angle ABC. So instead of this, we will write angle ABC. And see equation number 2. 180 minus angle QCB is equals to angle ACB. So instead of this, we will write angle ACB. So what conclusion we got? Angle ABC is greater than angle ACB. Now where is angle ABC? This is angle ABC. And where is angle ACB? This is angle ACB. Now if this angle is greater, then the side opposite to this angle will also be greater. So which side is opposite to this angle? This side. That means AC. So here AC will come, then greater than the side opposite to angle ACB. This angle, the side opposite to this is AB. So here AB will come. That means AC is greater than AB. And the reason for this will be side opposite to the greater angle is greater. And this is what we have to prove. So this is our answer. After this you can write, hence proved. Thank you everyone. If you like my videos, please like, subscribe and share my channel and stay connected with A1 Study Classes.